Good afternoon, my dear children. Welcome to today's maths class, chapter 9, statistics, part 5. Okay, children, in previous video, we have discussed how to find mean using raw data. So, what is the formula we have used there, children? Mean is equal to sum of the observations by number of observations. So, children, we denote mean by x bar, which is equal to sum of the observations means sigma xi by number of observations, we denote it by n. So, x bar is equal to sigma xi by n. Next, children, mean of ungrouped frequency distribution table. So, in the mean of ungrouped frequency distribution table, distribution, we have two methods, children. One is direct method or a simple method. And next one is deviation method or assumed mean method. So, we have already discussed how to find mean using direct method or simple method. So, what is the formula we have discussed in the previous video, children? X bar is equal to sigma fi into xi by sigma fi. So, using this direct method, we have solved few sums. So, based on that, let us do another model. Okay, children, let us move to example 1. Here, if the mean of the following distribution is 7.2, find the value of k. They have given observations as 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12. And frequency has 4, 7, 10, 16, k and 3. So, we have to find out the value of k. Okay, we have to find out the value of k. Now, let us represent this data in a tabular form, children. Here, what the observations are given here, children? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12. And frequency, what they have given, children? 4, 7, 10, 16, k and 3. Okay. So, now we have to find out the value of k. So, first, what we will do, children? Let us do the sum of the frequencies. Let us do all sum of the frequencies. So, first what? 4 plus 7, 11. 11 plus 10, 21. 21 plus 16, 37. 37 plus k, which is 37 plus k plus 3. How much you will get, children? 40 plus k. So, sum of the frequencies will denote it by sigma fi, children, which is equal to 40 plus k. What we did here, children, we added all the frequency here. So, sum of the frequency you got here, 40 plus k. Okay. Now, let us find the product of xi into fi. Means, these two you have to multiply, children. So, first one you see, 2 into 4, 8. Okay. 4 into 7, 28. 6 into 10, 60. Okay. 8 into 16, 128. 10 into k, 10k. Next, last one is 12 into 3 is 36. What we have done here, children, the product of xi into fi. Now, let us do the sum of this xi into fi. Means you have to add all this. So, 8 plus 28, how much? 36. 36 plus 60, 96. 96 plus 128 is 224. 224 plus 10k, you will get 224 plus 10k plus 36. You will get 260 plus 10k. Okay. Now, we have added fi into xi. We have added fi into xi. So, you will represent this as sigma fi into xi. How much we got, children? 260 plus 10k. So children, in the question they have given mean x bar is equal to 7.2. okay, now let us write the formula to find out the mean. X bar is equal to sigma fi xi by sigma fi. Now let us simplify this by substituting the values in the formula. X bar, how much they have given, children? 7.2, which is equal to sigma fi into xi, means sum, how much you got? 260 plus 10k by sigma fi, how much you got? 40 plus k. Now let us substitute this one, children. Let us cross multiply this one with 7.2. So 7.2 into 40 plus k, which is equal to 260 plus 10k. Okay, now let us multiply 7.2 into 40. How much will get? 288 plus 7.2 into k is 7.2k, which is equal to 260 plus 10k. Now let us transpose 260 to the left hand side. Then you will get 288 minus 260, which is equal to let us transpose 7.2k to the right hand side. You will get 10k minus 7.2k. So children, 288 minus 260, how much we'll get? 28. Okay, which is equal to 10k minus 7.2k is 2.8k. If you subtract 10k minus to 7.2k, you will get 2.8k. Now we have to find out the value of k. So k is equal to 28 by 2.8. So let us remove the decimal in the denominator, children. So let us multiply the numerator and denominator with 10. Okay, k is equal to 28 into 10 by 2.8 into 10. Then how much you will get, children? 280 by 28. 2.8 into 10 is 28, isn't it? So let us cancel. 28 ones are, 28 tens are. So the value of k is equal to 10. So children, in previous sum, we have used direct method to solve the sum. Okay. Now, next method is deviation method, or we can also call it as assumed mean method. Okay, assumed mean method of ungrouped data. When we will use this assumed method or a deviation method, children? When values of frequencies and observations are large, this method will help us to simplify the data easily. Okay. Okay, what is the formula for to find mean by assumed mean method, children? X bar is equal to A plus sigma x fi into di by sigma fi. Okay, this is a formula for finding out the arithmetic mean by using assumed mean method. Okay, so children, let us move to the example 2. Let us see how to find mean by using assumed mean method. Find the arithmetic mean of the following data. See the data here, children. 10, x observations they have given. 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22. And frequency they have given 4, 5, 8, 10, 7, 4 and 2. First, now let us represent this in a tabular form. So children, what they have given the data, we have represented this in a tabular form. Here observation x, what they have given? 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22. Next frequency, what they have given? 4, 5, 8, 10, 7, 4 and 2. So children, in this method, let us assume one of the observation. We can assume any one of the observations from the, any one of the observations here, children. Any which is convenient for us. We can assume 14. We can assume 18. Any observation you can assume it. Okay. So I have assumed 16 here. See, let us assume 16 and mark it as A. Okay. Now, next step, what you have to do, children? Let us do the sum of the frequencies. Means you have to add all the frequencies. So how much you will get here? 4 plus 5 plus 8 plus 10 plus 7 plus 4 plus 2, which is equal to 40. So you will represent this as sigma fi is equal to 40. Next, what we have to do, children, we have to find out deviations here. To find deviation here, you have what you have the formula here, di is equal to xi minus a. Okay, to how to find deviation, d is equal to xi minus a. So here, see, observe first column, children, here xi minus a means first one 10 minus A, 16. We have assumed A as 16, isn't it? So, from 10, you have to subtract 16. 10 minus 16, how much you will get? Minus 6. Next, 12 minus 16, minus 4. Next, what children? 14 minus 16 is minus 2. Next one, 16 minus 16, which is equal to 0. I hope so you all are understanding, children. Next, 18 minus 16, which will get 2. Next, 20 minus 16, 4. 22 minus 16, we will get the 6. Here, first three numbers you got negative values and last three numbers you got positive values, children. Now, next step, what we have to do? Now, we have to find out the product of frequency and deviation, means fi into di. These two you have to multiply, children. Okay. Now let us multiply it, children. 4 into 6 minus 24. 5 into minus 4 minus 20. 8 into minus 2 minus 16. 10 into 0, 0. 7 into 2, 14. 4 into 4, 16. 2 into 6, 12. We have done the product of fi into di. Now, next step, what we have to do? We have to add. We have to add fi and di. See, first let us add negative values, children. Minus 24, minus 20, minus 16. How much you will get there, children? 60. Minus 60 you will get there. Okay. Next, let us add all the positive values, 14, 16 and 12. So, how much you will get the children? 42. So, sigma fi di will represent the sum as sigma fi into di, which is equal to this all you got 60 minus 60 plus 42, which is equal to minus 18. So, how much you got, children, here? Sigma fi di is equal to minus 18. Now, let us find mean, arithmetic mean by using deviation method. So, what is the formula to find mean by deviation method? X bar is equal to A plus sigma fi di by sigma fi. Now, let us simplify this by substituting the values. So, A what we got here, children, what we have assumed A there, 16. So, 16 plus sigma fi di, how much you got? Minus 18. So, you write minus 18 in the bracket. Okay, by sigma fi, sum of the frequencies, how much you got? 40. Okay, now 16 plus of minus. Okay, first let us do 16 plus minus 18 by 40, if you divide this one, you will get in a form of decimal, minus 0.45. Okay, you have to do division there, children. So, it will be easy for us to simplify it. Okay, so 16 plus minus will become minus 0.45. 16 minus 0.45, how much will learn? 15.55. So this is how you will find out the mean by using deviation method. This is all for today, children. I hope so you have understood today's content. Rewatch the video for better understanding and complete the assignment given today. Thank you and have a nice day.